to start. No material differences in those figures except for one. A 4.5 inch edge in reach for Salvador Sanchez. So Castillo facing something like the problem he faced against Arguello. How to get inside and yet get out and stay out of trouble against the hard punching of Sanchez. Now, as you had seen Sanchez's record, you look at Castillo and you will see his record. And this kid is these are two classy fighters, quality fighters, who promise a rattling good scrap. The bell now for the start of round one will quickly give you the rules as we go. WBC rules, 10-point must scoring system, 3 knockdown rule waived, mandatory 8 count, no saving by the bell except for the 15th round, scheduled 15 rounder of course. Referee, no voice in the scoring, scoring by 3 judges. The referee is Bertini Marcello of Italy. 2 of the judges are Mexican, which gives one pause for thought since Sanchez is Mexican. And 1 judge is from California. Sanchez, who had a brilliant fight plan against Little Red Lopez and exposed Red's vulnerability to the right lead. Little Red in attendance here. He's supposed to fight the winner of this bout. World featherweight crown at stake. We're a minute 15 into round one. Ruben Castillo, the left of your screen, the champion in the white trunks with his back now to you, Sanchez. Castillo in tremendous shape. He was off balance, Sanchez was, as Castillo scored with a left. Just scored well with a combination in his fight against Arguello. He's back at natural weight now. Seems beautifully fit. Less than a minute to go in round one. Castillo used his left beautifully to pick off that Sanchez right. This a few seconds back. Steady ring movement and 2 good lefts by Castillo. I told you this kid's a classy fighter. His only loss has been to Arguello, where the superior reach and strength told. Counting down toward the end of round one. We're going to stay between rounds as we come to the end of it. And we will follow the champion, Salvador Sanchez, to his corner. One of the better fights of this year, the first fight between Sanchez and Little Red Lopez. And this young man astounding nearly everybody in the boxing world with his brilliant fight plan, the way he was able to execute it, the way he carried the fight to Little Red. Now, Ruben Castillo, who had a good first round, I thought, using his left well, scoring with it, and yet executing the neat trick that he must execute to be successful in this bout. Getting out of trouble, staying out of range after scoring successfully with his own blows. He's a very quick-footed, quick-handed fighter, Castillo. Employs lots of lateral movement. The bell for round two. We are live in Tucson, Arizona. to attack. Still effectively staying out of range. Notice how Castillo, so often up to this point, can make Sanchez miss. For 10 rounds, he led so great a fighter, Castillo did, as Alexis Arguello on points. Until Alexis, a superb puncher, caught him in the 11th. Quick-handed, he beat Sanchez to the punch in that quick exchange. And again, the left. Sanchez purposeful, looking for an opening for the spot. Once again, the third man in the ring is Bertini Marcello of Italy. Castillo unafraid in that exchange, taking it to Sanchez. Good left and right combination by Castillo. Say he looks so much quicker at this lower weight than he did against Arguello. Right there, Sanchez doubling and tripling on the jab, then the quick Castillo combination and an answering counterpunch by Sanchez. Good, swiftly paced fight thus far. But as I said, two quality fighters. Good left by Castillo. We're approaching the end of the second round. And a good scrap thus far. We're back live in Tucson. That's Salvador Sanchez, WBC featherweight champion of the world. We're in the third round. He is fighting Ruben Castillo. His championship at stake, his first title defense, coming in the wake of his brilliant victory over Little Red Lopez. But in the first two rounds, a very, very quick, superbly conditioned Castillo has been beating Sanchez to the punch, has been steadily on his toes with excellent lateral movement. The beauty to Sanchez is his patience. He is a patient fighter. Right there, he got in two good rights. One to the midriff, one to the chest. Each fighter is now 22 years of age, a pair of kids. Sanchez, 21, when he beat Lopez. And there, Sanchez scoring briskly. First with the left, then with the right in combination. And Sanchez thus far enjoying a much better round in this, the third round. Good left by Castillo. With his left. That's what he's been doing. Although in this third round to a lesser degree. Yes, we are live from Tucson, Arizona. The weather. Beautiful. And Castillo doing a good job beating the champion to the punch. And quickly getting his gloves up to pick off Sanchez blows. Right quickly in there, and Sanchez knows he's in a fight. Ruben Castillo, he was born in Billings, Montana. He's a resident of Bakersfield, California, a local hero in the manner of Frank Gifford, who of course during his halcyon days on the gridiron was notable among Bakersfield citizenry. This is round four, live from Tucson. And we opened on Castillo because he's been carrying the fight. He has been beating Sanchez, the champion, to the punch. He has been using the left and right in beautiful combination. He has been swift and precise, swift in his movements, fighting at a number of pounds lighter than he did against Alexis Arguello. And up till now, it's made, I think, a telling difference. But Sanchez, purposeful and patient, as I have noted. ABC Sports, as you know, has been on top of the Colorado Springs U.S. Olympic Committee and House of Delegates vote story with Jim Lampley as our correspondent there. It had been mentioned, and I want to make the point that it's not yet been confirmed, that the vote was apparently 2-1 not to send an American team to the Moscow Olympics in this, the year 1980. That had been reported, but it has not yet been confirmed. Now back to the action here in round four. Sanchez working more methodically in this round. A better round, I think, for Sanchez. Right there, the Sanchez right, which so dominated Little Red Lopez, was in evidence. Castillo must remain constantly wary. Sanchez can punch. And although that exchange was led by Castillo, it wound up with Sanchez's counterpunching giving him the better of it. This is the fourth round. Sanchez is left, working better in this round. And the round on its way to its conclusion. I tell you, that Ruben Castillo is a gutsy little gamester. Just winked at me as he was sitting in his corner about to come out for this, the fifth round. Indeed, I have him ahead in my personal and subjective scoring, 3-1 at this point, but the champion changed the tempo of the fight, as I saw it, in the fourth round, using his left effectively, his patience and method working, and even now as he is doing, and with perhaps superior upper body strength. Right, he's counterpunching now much more effectively. He just did it in one exchange and then scored well with the right. So Sanchez has come alive, and look at him go! This is the fifth round. And Sanchez continues to score with his counterpunching. These two kids reflect the way the lower weight classification fighters have taken over boxing in this country. The welterweights. We've told you about them. These are featherweights and include Little Red Lopez and the brilliant new lightweight champion, Hilmer Kenty of Detroit. Remember him? A kind of lowercase Sugar Ray Leonard. These guys provide the action these days as Larry Holmes stands alone among the heavyweights. I'd like to alert our stations along the line that we'll take a station break at the end of this round, which is round five. Barring action of a nature that compels us to stay here. Sanchez's counterpunching getting steadily more effective. Return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local stations. We're back live in Tucson, Arizona. Round six is underway. Castillo trying to reestablish his earlier dominance. He had a good second half of the last round. In the beginning of the round, Sanchez had been carrying the fight. That round might fairly have been called even. Remember, we have two Mexican judges and one California judge scoring this fight. Ramon Barrowman of Mexico, Jorge Velasco of Mexico, and Dr. James H. Jenkin of California. Saying a good right by Sanchez. Sanchez trying to make his own effort more and more aggressive at this point, trying to use the counterpunch because the Castillo youngster is so quick of hands, use the counterpunch with enormous effectiveness, and he's beginning to succeed. This is sixth round action. That exchange spoke for itself. Interesting point. Beto Martinez is, of course, co-manager, trainer, and chief second of Ruben Castillo. And yet he worked in Sanchez's corner for the Lopez fight. They're throwing a lot of punches. They're not connecting that much. At this point, excellent combination by young Castillo. This is round six, and shortly it will be history. A lot of missing. It is history. We're back live in Tucson, Arizona, round seven, WBC Featherweight Championship at stake. Sanchez in the white trunks, right of your screen, defending, and the challenger, Ruben Castillo. In perspective, it's been an excellent, rapidly paced fight. In the last round, both of them turned to counter-punching. That's more Sanchez's game than Castillo's. Castillo with the quicker hands, carried the fight in the early rounds. Fight seems to me to be getting closer. Castillo, B, the counter-punching by Sanchez, and excellent evidence of it. Sanchez's finishing counter-left, a strong blow. Minute and a half into this, the seventh round. That Castillo, oh, good right by Sanchez, who's been looking to get that in there. And Sanchez hurting Castillo at that point. Sanchez looking steadily stronger. And Castillo fell prey to the right lead there. And he is not throwing the punches in anywhere near the numbers that he did in the first three rounds. Excellent round, this the seventh round for the champion, Salvador Sanchez. As in the late stages, Castillo tries to come back, but without the earlier effectiveness. All right, quickly, for an update on the Olympic boycott story, here's Jim Lampley.
Had to be real fun.
We're back live. Thank you very much, Jim, for that report. Excellent coverage on Colorado Springs. Now, let's look at that right of Sanchez. There it was. Snap Castillo's head back. That action in the seventh round. I have this fight marked very, very close at this point. After seven rounds, Sanchez may be in stronger shape. And I thought that Castillo was superbly conditioned, because Castillo has not been throwing the punches the way he did earlier, and Sanchez is now catching him. There, you saw the right lead again after a good score by Castillo. But Sanchez catching him effectively with his counter-punching. This is the eighth round. Two essential points have brought Sanchez back. Well, maybe three. He's begun to land the right lead with greater frequency, and that's a tremendously effective blow. He has used the left in the recent three or four rounds with much greater efficiency than he did in the opening rounds of the fight. And his counterpunching has been methodical, purposeful. He knows how to pick his spots and how to get those answering blows in there. There was the right lead in there again. Now he's beginning to use his superior upper body strength to maul Castillo a bit. And here in the eighth round, well, we commented on a change of the tempo in the contest in the fourth round, beginning to go Sanchez's way. And he is sustaining that change tempo in his behalf. Yeah. missing more and more. Missing too many times, and always the danger of leaving yourself open, especially to so effective a counterpuncher as Sanchez. 45 seconds left in this, the eighth round. How Sanchez gets the left lead in more. Two misses, three misses by Castillo. Wasted effort. A long right and a follow-up left by Castillo as the eighth round comes to its close. Salvador Sanchez, now Ruben Castillo, ninth round action, live from Tucson, WBC featherweight crown at stake, Sanchez defending. Tough struggle. Fatigue figures to become a factor. In that case, beginning to wonder about Ruben Castillo. So quick, so active in the early going, but so much less so in the recent four or five rounds. Missing so often with his punches, especially in the last two. Right there. Castillo knew he had hurt Sanchez with a quick, short, crisp left right to the face. But look at Sanchez come back. We commented that he's a patient fighter, that he's a methodical fighter with an extraordinary ability to stick to a fight plan. And he's been doing it. Doing it very effectively. Well, referee Bertini Marcello with a cautioning note to Sanchez. Right, the left did not score. That left it. And Oz, Ruben did, but both blows missed. Forty seconds left in round nine. Punches of any authority landed in this round. And the end of round nine. We're back live in Tucson, Arizona, the Tucson Community Center, round 10, WBC featherweight crown at stake. Sanchez, back to you, defending, Ruben Castillo challenging. As we come to the 10th round, the fight is very, very close by most of the scoring at ringside. Castillo with a reasonably good comeback in the last round. There's that right lead. Another good right by Sanchez. keeps at you. He takes punishment well himself, and he keeps at you. Scoring very well in this round, Sanchez, thus far. Of course, it's no surprise when a Mexican fighter takes punishment well. They have, as a people, an extraordinary ability to do that. It's always been true of Mexican fighters in Olympic competition. A minute 45 into this, the 10th round. It's in the 10th round against Arguello that Castillo started to go downhill. Fatigue. Again, we'd like to alert our stations along the line. We'll take a station break at the end of this round. Sanchez scoring very well in this round. You saw the right. Way and an excellent round for Sanchez. Left's getting in there now. We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local stations. Against Castillo. Interesting to look at some of the scoring around ringside. I now have Sanchez slightly ahead. Some around here do not agree with that. They have it either even or Castillo slightly ahead. But as David Anderson once wrote in the Times, nothing so subjective in sports as scoring a fight. You can see now how you get a sense of the solidity of Sanchez as a fighter. How he fights so well mentally, so intelligently. Adhering to plan, not wasting punches, not missing as many as Castillo. One telltale sign of a maturity growth in a fighter is when he doesn't waste his punches, when he knows when to throw them and how, and at a designated area. A minute 30 into round 11. An answering right by Castillo evoked draws, but in general, Sanchez is dominating. Left uppercut and then the overhand right by Sanchez. Less than a minute left in round 11. Both Castillo blows were picked off and a third one missed. Sanchez now seeking to go to the midriff more. Seconds left in the round, and Sanchez is tattooing, or was, Castillo against the ropes. Castillo trying to come back and scoring. No quitting this kid. 10 seconds left and counting down in this, the 11th round. And Castillo is saying a big comeback here at the very end. Will stay between rounds. Look at that. Castillo exhorts the crowd. The fans stand behind him. He smiles as he looks up at his corner people. Beto Martinez, Jimmy Montoya, Carlos Medina, Vince Martinez over in the champion's corner. Sanchez with four people, four allowed in each corner. Look at that flurry. And there Castillo was scoring. So it became an exciting 11th round. It had been dominated by Sanchez, but what a comeback in the second half of the round by Castillo. Quality fight, two quality fighters. That's the way it was. Sanchez, the mouthpiece in. Cristobal Rosas, Angel Huitron, Tomas Sanchez, Raul Roldan. Those are the four in the champion's corner. A good quick right lead by Sanchez to open round 12. Fighters. A minute 25 into the 12th round. Madison Square Garden is a co-promoter of this fight. They can feel pretty good about it. Sanchez right. You swing wildly, you can pay the piper, as Volbrecht did last Sunday against Pepino Cuevas. Seconds left in the 12th round. See the countdown, the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Well, some wondered, could Castillo go 15 rounds? At this point in time, I see no reason to doubt it. We approach the end of round 12. Tucson Community Center live. Sanchez, right of your screen. Left of your screen, a fine little fighter, Ruben Castillo. Scorecards around the ring all mark this fight as very, very close. Some have Castillo slightly ahead. Some have Sanchez slightly ahead. Others have the fight even. Make your own scoring decision up till now. Sanchez effective with the right. Minute into the round. Round 13. slackening of effort now by either fighter. Things are too late and too close for that. Good left lead there by Castillo. Cut in. Castillo again with a flurry. Round a little more than half over. And a very good score by Castillo. A left, a right, and a left. Bang, bang, bang. And it hurt Sanchez. How do you like these shifting tides? The ebb and flow within a round as patterns change. One moment, one fighter. The next moment, another. They're right above us now. Seconds left. Round 13. Oh, an excellent counter left by Castillo after Sanchez had scored with a right. Every 20 seconds, one or another of the fighters takes sudden control, but only briefly. This is an action-packed 13th round. How would you score it? The round is here. The challenger, Ruben Castillo, coming out for round 14, giving an excellent account of himself against a very solid young champion. And they are, as I've noted, both kids, each only 22 years of age. The fight, by all accounts, a close one. Be interesting to see how those two Mexican judges scored. You just saw Sanchez score beautifully, doubling up on the right, scoring, and then doubling up again and scoring. A quick flashing left by Castillo. Kid has a way of coming back at you. Sanchez gives you a feeling, doesn't he, that he knows just what he's doing. Yes, he's human. He's been hurt by Castillo. But yet there is a composure there, a solidity. Little Red Lopez in attendance. Waiting for a shot at the winner. Wanting the crown he held so popularly back. So far, this has been an excellent round for Sanchez. As I said, an excellent round for Sanchez, though there is a touch of blood flowing from his nose. Totally the aggressor now. A big and very important round for Salvador Sanchez. You want to end a fight on a high note, always. It's an old cliche in boxing, but the truth of it is what makes it a cliche. Leave the big impression with the officials. Notice Castillo missing consistently. Tremendous effort, but all of it wasted. Now to our studios in New York. Well, their back, there is the defending champion. The final round, round 15, about to come up. And looking back to 14, a flurry by Sanchez in what was a very big and I think very important round for him as he teed off on young Castillo. But every other 20 seconds, as noted, there are shifting tides in this fight. And the way Castillo has fought it, you've got to have all the respect in the world for him. The bell for round 50, the final round. The time to make the most compelling score possible. But now, Sanchez in that exchange beat Castillo to the punch. Picked off one Castillo blow, the other blow was missed. The left was scored by Sanchez. Now every blow counts, every score counts, assuming that the officials have this fight as close as most everybody at ringside thinks it's been. There was a good left by Castillo. To go in the fight, and a good right by Sanchez. Sanchez is now throwing the heavier leather. I think it's fair and clear to say that. Been a sparkling effort by both men. Again, the missing by Castillo. However, it's not enough for Sanchez to make Castillo miss. He must score himself, and Castillo got in a good right. But back comes Sanchez. And he is, see, wild punching, missing. Actually, four misses there by Castillo. And a fifth. Left to go in this fight. Castillo missing and caught by the counterpuncher. And there, two quick lifts by Sanchez. By detailing the blows at this point in the fight, and in this kind of fight, perhaps you can get a feel for the winner of the round. We have 20 seconds left. And if there's any question about Castillo's ability to go 15 rounds, the question exists no longer. A good left by Castillo. The fight is over. And both men are entitled to this standing ovation from the crowd. It has been an exceptional effort by the two of them. Nothing asked for, nothing given, a lot taken. It has really been a sparkling bout. Cleveland Indians just got out of town, opened against the Angels, got whacked 10-2, and a malaise had settled over this beautiful and growing city because they take their team.
Our new house is costing plenty, so...
All right, we're back live in Tucson, Arizona for the decision in this, the WBC featherweight title fight. Now... The ring announcer on the verge of announcing it. Sanchez came up with two splendid rounds in the 14th and the 15th.
Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Dr. Jim Kim rules it Castillo 141. Sanchez 145. Judge Jorge Velasco rules it Castillo 144. Sanchez 147. Judge Ramon.
So he is the winner.
142.
By unanimous decision, and still the WBC featherweight champion of the world, Salvador Sanchez. And while the fans were rooting for Ruben Castillo, take nothing away from the young man's fine performance, but in truth, I thought Sanchez had earned a close decision, especially by his performance in the late rounds. So there it is, and some may argue about it, but the winner and still the champion, a purposeful, solid fighter with a superb right lead. He used the left effectively, and he was the winner. Let's go to our colleague, Frank Gifford, in Aspen, live Tucson, Arizona. I'm with the man who successfully defended his title, Salvador Sanchez, as you look at him, and the man who was such a valiant challenger, Ruben Castillo. First to you, Mr. Quinlan, his interpreter. Does this mean the return match with Little Red Lopez?
Yes, this our next fight is the return match with Little Red.
All right, we're looking at a typical late round flurry. Your man came through in the final two rounds, and I think that turned the bout for him. Would you agree?
Yes, the condition paid off, I think, in the end.
Okay, thank you very much.